just even the term radical growth is something that can scare people.
I think the scary part is, like, what's the thing we haven't thought of yet?
Fear can be a good motivator. It can get people actively aware and aggressive about looking at their future, but it can also create paralysis.
The challenge is seeing where the opportunity is and innovating faster than everybody else.
First of all, we have to be built for change.
One of the biggest challenges I have in running large business is trying to manage the existing cash flow and quarterly responsibilities that we feel, plus trying to make the investments necessary to anticipate where things are going.
It's not an easy equation, because you've got to keep the lights on and you've got to keep a core business running while you're thinking about the possible disruptors or disruption that's coming your way.
And you have to start to ask the fundamental questions again.
Get out of your office, get out of your headquarters, get into a space where you're with such strikingly different people and in stunningly different places, where you're going to end up being so wrong and uncomfortable and forced to be quiet that a new question is going to pop out of nowhere.
Boom! It's really essential that an organization or a company sees itself as part of a wider ecosystem that a lot of capability sits outside of their immediate organization. So people are no longer just looking vertically, but are in fact looking across the whole context in which they operate.
I love the idea of a dual strategy where you accept the idea that you have to run the business for current performance and meet your objectives of the business as it exists, but you always have to be aware that the business is evolving into something else if it wants to stay current or lead its market.
Enterprises everywhere are looking for help on how to enable, how to accelerate, how to become more digital, whatever that even means.
Because things are moving so much faster, if we get ourselves in that mindset of acceleration, I think the other question is, how do we balance the present and the future?
Separation of incremental innovation and radical innovation is really important, where the business units need to focus on innovations that are close to the core, that are adjacent. That's their responsibility. But for the most part, the traditional business units need to focus on the short-term profitability of the business that's going to produce revenue for us today.
Set aside a group of people with different priorities, different incentives, frankly, different type of skills, and let them play with disruptive technologies while most of your business units and most of your country teams and your brand managers are focusing on iterating on the current business.
That separation is important, different mindset, but also different talent. So bringing in people from the outside to help move those ideas forward in different ways using different methodologies has been very helpful.
And successful organizations learn both from top down and from down up.
Who you are and who you want to be can contort a bit and change and morph and evolve while still being true to the core business and the core brand.